الحمد لله رب العالمين. اللهم صل وسلم وبارك على محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم أجمعين. اللهم اجعل اجتماعنا هذا اجتماعا مرحوما، وتفرقنا من بعده تفرقا معصوما، ولا تجعل فينا ولا منا شقيا ولا محروما. اللهم آمين. وقفنا الأسبوع الماضي عند حديثنا عن حياة السيدة فاطمة وزوجها علي بن أبي طالب، وقلنا بأنهما عاشا حياة تقشف، فكان يمر بهم اليوم واليومان، وربما لا يوجد في بيتهما قوت. والآن نبدأ بحديثنا. قال علي لفاطمة ذات يوم: والله لقد سنوت. سنوت يعني تعب من جلب الماء، وكانوا يعني يحطوا الدلو في البئر ويسحبوا به. قال: والله لقد سنوت حتى لقد اشتكيت صدري. We're still talking about the legacy of Ali ibn Abi Talib. And last thing that we mentioned last week about the nature of his lifestyle, it was very hard lifestyle. And we said that Ali ibn Abi Talib mentioned after his marriage, he did not find any sustenance at his home to satisfy himself and his wife. Right now we're going to begin with the story of Ali ibn Abi Talib once said to Fatima, "By Allah, I'm experiencing a very severe chest pain from the amount of water that I'm pulling out of the well." They used to throw the bucket in the well and then they have to pull it up. So it's, "By Allah, I have chest pain." And that tells you the amount of water that he used to pull, that he pulled out of the well in a day. قال: وجاء أباك وجاء الله بأباك وجاء قال وجاء الله أباك بسبي. يعني الله عز وجل أعطى والدك سبي عبيد. فلما لا تذهبي وتسأليه عن عبد يساعدنا في الخدمة؟ قالت: أنا والله قد طحنت حتى من ملجت يداي. Not only, it's not only you, Ali ibn Abi Talib, who's suffering of a chest pain. Also me. I'm complaining about a very severe pain for the amount of grinding that I do during the day. فأتيت النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم فقال: ما جاء بك؟ يعني علي بن أبي طالب قال لفاطمة: اذهبي واسألي أبيك عن أحد يساعدنا. Go ask your father for some assistance. He is the leader and he loves you so much. So I'm sure he's not going to let you down or turn you down. قالت: فذهبت. فقال: ما جاء بك أي بنية؟ And the Prophet of Allah told me, "What do you want? What brought you here?" قالت: جئت لأسلم عليك. He said, "Oh father, I'm here to say السلام عليكم." Nothing less, nothing more. She felt shy to ask the Prophet of Allah, her own father, for assistance. واستحييت أن أسأله ورجعت. فقال علي: ما فعلت؟ قالت: استحييت أن أسأله. She went back home empty-handed. Ali told her, "What's the news? What did you get?" Said, "I did not ask him anything." قال علي: تعالي لنسأله. Ali ibn Abi Talib is not satisfied with this answer. He sent Fatima for a reason. And he's expecting some assistance, some help from Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. فقال علي يا رسول الله والله لقد سنوت حتى اشتكيت صدري. O Prophet of Allah, I have very severe chest pain from the amount of water that I'm pulling out. وقالت فاطمة قد طحنت حتى مجلت يداي. Also Fatima told her, oh father, I need some hand, some help. فقال والله لا أعطيكما وأدع أصحاب الصفة خاوية بطونهم. By Allah, I am not going to give you anything and leave my companions, Ahlul Sufa, the poor people, waiting for my help. Their empty stomach. They have an empty stomach. Nothing to eat, nothing to show for. Basically, the group of people, they lived at the masjid, waiting for the Prophet of Allah to support them and to feed them. So Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam told, how can I give you and leave them and neglect Ahlul Sufa? What I do with the slave that I get from the war, I sell them and I buy food for Ahlul Sufa. ثم قال لهم فرجع فأتاهما النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم وقد دخلا في قطيفتهما. They went back home and they went in their bed to sleep. في قطيفتهما, then they put their blanket on. But that blanket, it was too short. If they cover their feet, their head will be uncovered. And if they pull that blanket up to cover their head, their feet will be uncovered. Could you imagine? How could you sleep in a tent in the desert with a shorter blanket? It's not long enough to cover the whole body. So Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he knocked on the door and he asked for the permission, and quickly he went under the blanket with them. And they want to move for the Prophet of Allah, and the Prophet of Allah told them, no, remain in there. Should I tell you, or should I tell you about something, it will be better for you than what you came to ask me for? You're requiring from me financial help. But I'm going to tell you about something even better than that. Spiritual help. فدخل النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم على فاطمة وعلي وقد دخلوا في قطيفتهما, يعني في فراشهما, وعليهما لحاف لو غطى رجليهما انكشف رأسهما ولو غطى رأسهما انكشفت رجليهما. فدخل النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم معهما في الفراش ثم قال ألا أعلمكما شيئا هو خير لكما مما سألتماني. I'm here to tell you about something, it will be more beneficial to you than the financial help that you came for. Make sure when you finish your prayer, say Subhanallah 10 times, and Alhamdulillah 10 times, Allahu Akbar 10 times. قال قولوا قولا بعد كل صلاة Subhanallah 10. والحمد لله عشرا والله أكبر عشرا ولا تدعى أن تقولا إذا أويتما إلى الفراش سبحان الله 33 والحمد لله 33 والله أكبر 34. And make sure when you go to bed, right when you settle on that mattress of yours and that bed of yours, you say Subhanallah 33 times, Alhamdulillah 33 times, Allahu Akbar 34 times. Many of us, they experience a bad dream. But the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam gave us the medicine. It could be your last moment in life. Make sure in that period of time with good deeds. There's a possibility that you won't wake up tomorrow. So might as well end that life with Subhanallah, Alhamdulillah, Wallahu Akbar. فهذا تعليم النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم لفاطمة. محبة رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم للسيدة فاطمة. وعن ثوبان رضي الله تعالى عنه قال كان رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم إذا سافر آخر عهده بالمدينة إتيان فاطمة. النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم before he traveled or any time he wanted to travel out of the Medina, the last thing of his activity, he visits Fatima to say goodbye to her. And when he comes back, the first or the second of his activity, his first of his activity, he offered 2 rak'ah at the masjid. And the second of his activity, he visits Fatima to say assalamu alaikum. وفي رواية عن أبي ثعلب الخشني قال كان رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم إذا قدم من غزو أو سفر بدأ بالمسجد فصلى فيه ركعتين ثم يأتي فاطمة ثم يأتي أزواجه. وعن عائشة رضي الله تعالى عنها قالت ما رأيت أحدا أشبه سمتا ولا دلا برسول الله في قيامه وقعوده من فاطمة. Here you go. There's another hadith tells us the connection and the relationship between Aisha and Fatima. Aisha's mentioned that I haven't seen anyone who acts exactly the same as the Prophet of Allah better than Fatima or more than Fatima. The way how she sit and the way how she talk and the way how she walk, exactly like the Prophet of Allah. وعن أسامة بن زيد قال قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم أحب أهل بيتي إلي فاطمة. The most beloved people to me, my daughter Fatima, the Nabi صلى الله عليه وسلم mentioned. You know what? There's a story that once Ali ibn Abi Talib, he got that thought it would be a good idea for him to get married. And then he mentioned the daughter of Abu Jahl. And Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, by Allah, this is will never happen. وعن المسور بن مخرم رضي الله تعالى عنه أنه سمع رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم على المنبر يقول بني هاشم بن المغيرة استأذنوني أن ينكح ابنتهم علي بن أبي طالب. The family of Bani Hashim, they're asking, they're requiring from me a permission to allow them to marry their daughter to Ali. فلا آذن لهم ثم لا آذن لهم ثم لا آذن لهم. They're not getting my permission. 3 times the Nabi صلى الله عليه وسلم mentioned, they're not getting my permission. إلا أن يحب ابن أبي طالب أن يطلق ابنتي وينكح ابنتهم. In one condition. Only if Ali want to divorce my daughter, and then he can marry their daughter. ثم قال وإني لست أحرم حلالا ولا أحل حراما ولكن والله لا تجتمع بنت رسول الله وبنت عدو الله في مكان واحد أبدا. النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم said, I am not trying to change the ruling here. I'm not making the permissible unpermissible. I'm not trying to make the halal haram or the haram halal. But by Allah, my daughter and the daughter of Aduwullah, the enemy of Allah, they cannot live in one home. It's impossible for them to be in one house. وروى الترمذي بسنده إلى عبد الله بن الزبير رضي الله تعالى عنه أن عليا ذكر ابنة أبي جهل فبلغ ذلك النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم فقال إنما فاطمة بضعة مني يؤذيني ما آذاها ويتعبني ما أتعبها. Another hadith that the Prophet of Allah heard that Ali رضي الله تعالى عنه is mentioning the daughter of Abu Jahl. And quickly Nabi صلى الله عليه وسلم made a very clear statement. Fatima is part of me. I suffer for her suffering. Now, subhanAllah, when you go through the translation or the statement of the ulama about this hadith, Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam was married to more than one wife. So why he did not allow Ali to marry two? Is it permissible for him and permissible for the rest of the ummah? There are so many opinions in there, but subhanAllah, yes, somehow you cannot really explain it. And the most comfortable opinion, they said that Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, because he said, I'm not trying to make the halal haram, so he's talking as a father, not as a prophet. As a father, he's not going to allow this. And there's another opinion that the scholar said, when Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Wallahi la yajtami'a, that means he received the news from Allah azza wa jal that this marriage will never go through. But again, it's very hard to convince the other to translate the hadith, but the hadith does exist. Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, عندما قال Wallahi la yajtami'a, يعني قد يقول الإنسان لما تزوج النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم أكثر من واحدة ورفض لعلي أن يتزوج على فاطمة؟ هل هذا جائز للنبي وغير جائز لغيره؟ قال بعض العلم أن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم عندما تحدث بهذا الكلام كان يتحدث بمقام الأب لا بمقام النبوة. As a father, he doesn't feel comfortable to put his daughter in this kind of marriage. And he made it clear, I suffer for her suffering. وفي حديث آخر قال إني أخاف أن تفتتن في دينها. I am afraid that she lose her faith because of jealousy. So this marriage is not going through. And we heard in the previous sessions that Ali ibn Abi Talib has 17 kids. But from more than one wife. And he got married to them after the death of Fatima. رَوَى الْحَاكِمُ بِإِسْنَادِهِ إِلَىٰ عَائِشَةَ رَضِيَ اللَّهُ تَعَالَىٰ عَنْهَا. Again, another hadith. Another statement from Aisha. أَنَّهَا كَانَتْ إِذَا ذَكَرَتْ فَاطِمَةَ بِنْتِ النَّبِي صَلَى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ قَالَتْ ما رأيت أحدا كان أصدق لهجة منها إلا أن يكون الذي ولدها. By Allah, I haven't seen anyone who's powerful in the speech and truthful in it more than Fatima, except her father. Except her father. والنبي صلى الله عليه وسلم قال حسبك من نساء العالمين مريم ابنة عمران وخديجة بن خويلد بنت خويلد وفاطمة بنت محمد وآسية امرأة فرعون. It's enough for you, the Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam mentioned, it's enough for you to know that the best among the female is four. مريم بن عمران وخديجة بنت خويلد, the wife of the Prophet of Allah, وفاطمة بنت محمد, the daughter of the Prophet of Allah, وآسيا امرأة فرعون. They are the best among the best. النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم ولد له علي بن أبي طالب ولد له الحسن والحسين. We're going fast, inshallah. Tomorrow we're gonna stop and talk about the death of the Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم and everything that and what took a place in ثقيفة بني ساعدة in ثقيفة بني ساعدة right after the death of Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم, because this is what we want to learn. We're gonna skip all the information because the information will be repeated inshallah with us, so there's no point going through it. But what we need to learn is the death of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and everything that took place right after it. So Nabi Ali ibn Abi Talib gave birth to Al-Hasan wal-Husayn. Anyone know what knows what the name of the Hasan was? Hasan. $1 gift. $1 prize. If you know. الحسن بن علي بن أبي طالب ست رسول الله وريحانته في الدنيا وأحد سيدي شباب أهل الجنة. أمه فاطمة الزهراء, ولد للنصف من رمضان سنة 3 للهجرة. هذا وقد سماه رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم حسنا. قال علي رضي الله تعالى عنه: لما ولد الحسن سميته حربا. So the one who named Al-Hasan with this name, it was the Prophet of Allah, his grandfather, the Prophet of Allah, not his father. His father named him Harb. Harb means war. So when you hear the words of Harb, war, it gives you like not comfortable feeling. So Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam did not like the name. فجاء رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم وقال أروني ابني ما سميتمو, show me my own son, my son. What did you name him? قلت حربا, قال بل هو حسن. مرحبا. And this was the sunnah at the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam to change the names to better name. He changed the name of Zainab bint Umm Salama. ما كان اسمها؟ كان اسمها برة. قال لا تزكوا على الله أحد. برة, the meaning of برة, she's pious. Pious. So how do you know? It's in the hand of Allah. No, change her name to Zainab. Al-Madina, the name of the Medina before the arrival of the Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم was? Yathrib. See? It was the sunnah of the Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم. I get many calls about people, they name their children Malak. This is this like name. وَجَعَلُوا الْمَلَائِكَةَ الَّذِينَ هُمْ عِبَادُ الرَّحْمَنِ إِنَاثًا. You cannot name a female with the name of Malak, because the Malak is the angel. Angels are not female. There are so many names, people nowadays, they don't pay attention to the names. They just look at the tone of the name. That sounds good. That sounds good. And now we begin to say Katarina, Lina, Mona Lisa, things like that. Subhanallah, what's wrong with Fatima and Khadija and Aisha? All the style. See? All the style. So we need to pay attention to the name. Do your homework. And subhanAllah, now Sheikh Google is very, very, very friendly. You can go on Sheikh Google, you search for the meaning of the name. Before you give your child that name, just Google it. Google it. And then you'll know if the name is good or not. When Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam يعني كان روي في الحديث أنه أذن في أذني الحسن حين ولدته فاطمة بالصلاة. This is another, you guys will be surprised now if you hear this from me. Because 99% of people, they think it's the sunnah to call the adhan in the ear of the child. And the iqama in his left hand, left ear. The hadith is very weak. الحديث ضعيف ضعيف جدا ومن العلماء من قال بعدم صحته. So the hadith of calling the adhan in the right ear and the iqama in the left one is very weak. But people, they are used to it. That's fine. We don't tell people don't do it. But don't believe it's is the very strong sunnah. وحدثنا أبو رافع عن عقيقة الحسن قال لما ولدت فاطمة حسنا قالت ألا أعق عن ابني بدم قال صلى الله عليه وسلم لا ولكن احلقي رأسه وتصدقي بوزن شعره من فضة على المساكين. فاطمة came to the Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم after after she gave birth to الحسن and said, should I slaughter a sheep as a aqiqa? Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam told her, no, I'll do that. But what I want you to do, shave his head, weigh the hair, and donate the value of the ear, the hair, or the weight. Just weigh the hair. And then put fudba on the other side of the scale, and donate that silver for the sake of Allah Azza wa Jalla. So basically, you put the hair in one side of the scale, and silver on the other side, just to make it equal to each other, and then donate it for the sake of Allah Azza wa
Jalla.
Now, Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam قال عن سعيد المقبري قال كنا مع أبي هريرة رضي الله تعالى عنه فجاء الحسن بن علي بن أبي طالب علينا فسلم فرددنا عليه السلام ولم يعلم أبو هريرة فقلنا يا أبا هريرة هذا الحسن بن علي قد سلم علينا فلحقه وقال عليك السلام يا سيدي ثم قال إنه سيد. النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم mentioned that حسن والحسين he is the leader of the Shabab Ahl al-Jannah, the youth of heaven. And once the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam قال إِنَّبْنِي هَذَا سَيِّد. My son, he is a leader. وَعَسَى اللَّهُ عَزَّ وَجَلَّ أَنْ يُصْلِحَ بِهِ بَيْنَ فِئَتَيْنِ مِنَ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ عَظِيمَتَيْنِ. And ask Allah Azza wa Jal to make him able to solve the differences between two group of believers. قال أهل العلم أن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم هذا من معجزات النبوة أن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم علم أنه ستكون فتنة بين المسلمين وسيكون الحسن بن علي هو من يصلح بين المسلمين فتنازل عن الخلافة لمعاوية حقنا لدماء المسلمين فكان هذا مصداق حديث النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم. النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم once was delivering the Jumu'ah speech. And Al-Hasan and Al-Husayn, they came walking and tripping over people. And Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam went down at the minbar, carried the Hasan and Al-Husayn, وَقَالَ صَدَقَ اللَّهُ إِنَّمَا أَمْوَالُكُمْ وَأَوْلَادُكُمْ فِتْنَةٌ. And then he carried Hasan and Al-Husayn and said, by Allah, Allah Azza wa Jal is the truthful one. He said, your children and your wealth is a trial for you. The means of a trial. والنبي صلى الله عليه وسلم يقول كان يقول اللهم إني أحبهما اللهم أحب من أحبهما Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam mentioned in one of the hadith, "Oh Allah, I love my grandchildren." So Allah Azza wa Jal love those who love them. نحن نحب الحسن والحسين وضمن عقيدة أهل السنة حب الحسن والحسين ونحن نلعن من قتل الحسن ومن قتل الحسين ومن أمر بقتل الحسين ومن قطع رأس الحسين لأن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم قال وأحب من أحبهما وأمرنا. It's part of our belief. The love of Al-Hasan Al-Husayn is part of our belief. They're the grandchildren of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. When Nabi sallallahu alaihi wasallam told us to pay the due respect to both of them. No one can say that we're this Ahl Sunnah, we hate Al-Hasan Al-Husayn. No way. No way. And no one can hold us accountable for what happened to Al-Husayn. لأن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم لأن الحسن البصري ماذا قال هذه فتنة قد عصم الله أيدينا منها وعصم الله دماءنا منها ألا نعصم ألسنتنا عنها. When Hassan al-Basri was asked about the trial, about what happened, the incident of what happened to Al-Husayn, فماذا قال؟ قال this is a very scary trial that Allah Azza wa Jal kept us safe from it. Why don't we abstain ourselves from talking in that subject? We didn't take part of it. We didn't participate in it. So might as well don't speak about it. Don't speak about it. والنبي وعلي بن أبي طالب أنجب الحسين. صلوات. سؤال الحسن والحسين هما أولاد علي بن أبي طالب من فاطمة رضي الله تعالى عنها وأرضاها. Tomorrow, inshallah, we're gonna speak about the death of the Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم. We'll speak about his sickness, the last days that he spent in the Medina, and who was leading the prayer during his absence, and what happened of the covenant in the place of Bani Sa'ida. It's very important news, and to realize why Fatima and Ali, they did not participate in the covenant to begin with. So this subject will be very interesting, inshallah, azza wa jal. So be here at 10 o'clock, inshallah, and we'll continue. We'll catch you after that.